I'm going to add a rectangle to the screen and a diamond to the screen. Then under our flowchart, it's a process box and a decision. In my connectors toolbar, if I click on the straight line connector, we see little X's appear on the shapes we've added. Most noticeably, they're on our process box, but not our rectangle. If we click on this line in our arrows toolbar, the X's disappear. When I click on my line that ends with an arrow, the X's show up again. But they're really not meant to. I believe this is just a bug in the current release of LibreOffice. Why I say this is a bug is because those little X's are really glue points for the connectors. Lines are just like shapes, and unless they're grouped, they have no way of staying connected to another shape. Glue points, on the other hand, snap the connectors to a shape glue points, or handles on the shapes that don't have glue points, and they allow the connectors to remain connected to the shape when we move, resize, or rotate the shape. This makes connectors very useful, especially for flowcharts and org charts. I'm going to add a circle to the page and a rectangle. I want to add a connector from the bottom of the circle to go to the right side of the top of my rectangle. We see that it wants to jump to the center and connect to that handle, but I want it over here to the right side. Now I can get it pretty close, but if I touch that line, it jumps to the center. If I click on my box and move it up a little bit, it looks like my connector is attached to my rectangle, but when I move the rectangle, the connector is not attached. To attach my arrow on this part of the rectangle, I'm going to need to add a glue point. To add a glue point, we want to go over to Edit, Glue Points, and bring up our Glue Points toolbar. The object that we want to add our glue point is already selected, but I'm going to click off and then back on it just to stress the point that we want to click on the object before we add our glue point. Now I'm coming down to the glue points, insert glue point, and when I click this, now when I go back into my object, I've got a little crosshair, and when I click, I can add a glue point. And I'm going to put another one right along the side here. I can put in as many as I like around the edge or inside, as long as it's a filled object. Now if I click on my connector, I can attach it to my rectangle. And I still have my crosshair, so I want to hit Escape to get out of Insert Glue Point mode. Clicking on my rectangle, if I moved around, we see that our connector is connected to the right side, just where we want it. I'm going to make a copy of this slide and remove our connector. I want to add another glue point to our rectangle. To do that, I need to turn back on our glue points toolbar, and this time I'm going to do it from our draw toolbar. I'm going to select my rectangle, click on insert glue point, and I'm going to place this on the upper right-hand side, right inside our rectangle. Now I'm going to change the fill area to be invisible and try and insert another one inside our rectangle. And we see that that doesn't work, but the one that we already placed inside the rectangle remains. So it will let me place one on the side of the rectangle, but not inside, because the fill area was invisible. Let's turn back on the fill area. Let's make it a gradient. How about yellow and white? So we can see the one that we placed earlier, the one on the edge. We don't want this anymore. To remove it, I've got my arrow over it, and we can see a little box to the lower right-hand side of the arrow. See, now it's gone. We got the crosshair. But when I'm over that X, I've got an arrow with a little box. I'm going to left-click it to select it, and then right-click it to bring up my shortcut. And although you can't see it, it's got cut. Let's add another one so you can see the whole process. I'm adding it. I'm right-clicking on it. I'm left-clicking. And here we can see I used cut. So that's how we remove a glue point that we don't want. I'm going to add one more inside the rectangle off to the lower left-hand side. On our glue points toolbar, we have exit direction from left, exit direction from top, exit direction from right, and exit direction from bottom. For this one on the lower left, I'm clicking it when I have the arrow with the little box. And I want this one to only allow exit from the left and exit from the right. We can see that these two are selected. Now I'm going to select our other glue point that's inside the rectangle. I've got the little box to the lower right of the arrow. I'm left clicking, and we see that nothing is selected again. But this one, I want to exit only from the top or the bottom. So we see that they're selected here. If I click on our other glue point, we see that it changes to only the left and the right. Now to get out of glue point insert mode, I'm hitting escape. And I'm going to attach a connector from our circle down to our glue point inside the lower left-hand corner. And we see it's on the left. If I click on our object and move it over to the right, we see that it can only go from the left or the right. Now let's move our connector to the other glue point. And it's only from the top or the bottom. Let's bring up that glue points toolbar again. So we've seen how to insert a glue point. We know how to delete a glue point and move it as well. We just need to click on it and we can move it around, move it back, and then right clicking brings up the little menu. I'm going to remove our line to make it easier to see the glue points in our rectangle. And over to our right on our glue points toolbar, we have glue point vertical bottom, vertical center, and vertical top. But they're inactive. To turn them on, we need to click on a glue point. I'm going to click on this one on the upper right-hand side of our rectangle. Now that I've clicked it, we have our exit direction, bottom and top, both highlighted. So is our glue point relative, that's active. We want to inactivate it by clicking on it. And now we see that it goes to the defaults of glue point horizontal center and vertical center. For this glue point, I'm going to click on glue point horizontal right. And what we're going to see here is when I resize the box, it should stay the same position from the right to our new glue point. Whereas this one's going to be relative, so this one's going to change with the length of the box. Now I'm going to click our other glue point that's in the center, and I'm going to turn off glue point relative. And this one, I'm going to change glue point vertical bottom. So this one should stay the same position from the bottom of our rectangle to our glue point, whereas this other glue point is going to change when we change the length of our left-hand side. Let's try it out. I'm going to make our rectangle taller, and we see that our inside rectangle did not change to the bottom of our rectangle, but the glue point on the side of the rectangle did move its position, because it was relative. Let's try it now by moving our rectangle longer to the left. And we see that this glue point didn't move with its position to the right-hand side. And if I move it to the right, it still keeps the same distance.